Ladies and gentlemen, there's a reason I say hacks bring me stacks. There really is. Let me show you this. Here we are. Here we are amongst a mini sea of condensers. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We also have a misting system for the pool area. We also have a chiller, refrigeration chiller for a wine cellar. The reason why I say hacks bring us stacks is because you see this aux box right here? You see it? It's a 36,000 BTU system. See that 36? That means it's 3 tons. It came factory charged with 5 pounds, 14 ounces, almost 6 pounds of 410A, right? See that? It says 410A on there, right there. But guess where it doesn't say 410A?
No, and it's not the QR codes you can donate to the Mikey Pipes Philanthropy Charitable Organization. It is, dun, 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 the air handler. Yep, they didn't make that R410A, that's for sure.
And in case you're wondering, Mikey Pipes, you know, you could change the TXV and make it a 410A system. Well, not really, but if you really wanted to, I guess you could be a hack and you'll bring me stacks. But let me show you the TXV. There it is. There's the TXV, okay? And let's see, hold on. I'm waiting to show you 410A on there. Let's see, is there a 410A anywhere on there? Oh, I see a 22. Is that a 22 right there, center of the screen? That says 22, oh.
Yep, so that's what they did. They made it a 410A system without changing the TXV, without doing anything actually, except changing the outdoor unit, and
that's just no bueno. That's just no bueno.
All right, before we get started, taking this thing apart, a couple things to keep in mind. Make sure we work safely. I have our power off, and I tested with a voltmeter, my incoming power voltage. This is a 240 volt, 24 amp secondary transformer. It's going to this wire nest of stuff here. Let's not be confused by that, right? I'll show you easy step-by-step ways of identifying that. But before we get started, guys, check out my brand new Nipix needle nose, right? This thing is awesome. We crimp from 12 to 20 gauge. It's a needle nose. It also wire strips 12 and 14 gauge wire. And it really is pretty damn sweet. Nipix. Check this out. I got this on Amazon. Do not cut steel. Oh, Superman won't like this one. I got this on Amazon, and I'll put a link in the description box down below. It's not cheap. I think it was like 70 bucks or 60 bucks, but it's pretty cool. Let's check it out. And by the way, not a sponsor of the channel.
All right, so we have several wires coming in here. We have one wire right here, and it's usually going to always, the one with the thicker wire is always going to be our thermostat. And sure enough, it says Zone 8 Thermo Kitchen. And but easy way of telling that is, if long as these knuckleheads did it right, our red wire, right, will always be our 24 volts, generally. But if we're unsure, we'll follow it. See, now the red wire is going to our blue, and the yellow, right, is our common. So, cut that out there, and cut that out right there, okay? The rest of the stuff, I know where it's going, but we have a white wire going to a fan relay, right there, okay? And we have a green wire, right? Looks like it's going through here, not there, not there, but here. And that looks like it's going to a different fan relay. That's our green wire, okay? I'll cut that out as well, okay? Now, We also have in this mess of stuff, right? We have an orange wire going to red. All right, and this says T condenser. So two condenser, okay? So our yellow, right, from our thermostat is going to one wire, or the yellow wire going to our condenser. And the opposite condenser wire is always gonna go to common, which is where it was. See that? Okay. I'll put that out here. I'll put that out here. Now, we've already eliminated one wire. What you sometimes may also see is that condenser wire leaving our thermostat, or going to our thermostat, and going before it goes to the condenser, we can break the float switch. And if you stick around later on this video, we're gonna put in a new float switch, not only on the condensate pump, but also on the float switch coming out of the primary drain. Okay, back to here. Now, we have a hydro coil up here. So we know we're gonna have two wires going to our boiler. All right, let's see if we can find those two wires. Let's see what this one is right here. Two zone at boiler. See that? And that one, all right, it's utilizing a lot of wires here, or is it? We are, look, we have the red and the white going to our relay right there, and we have the blue and the yellow going to the black and the orange from our thermostat. We're gonna have to take a look at the thermostat and see how these wires are purposed. All right, so here's our Honeywell thermostat. Let's carefully take that off the wall. And let's take a look at our wiring. And we have different sets of wires here. So let's see if we can pull these out. Yep, so those other wires, they're cut, as you can see. There's our orange, there's our black, there's our brown. They're not being utilized, but what's perfect here is that we're easily gonna be able to upgrade this so we can do a dual fuel heat pump system for heating. Perfect. Hi, Daniel.
Hi.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, yesterday.
Don't give him a date.
Why not?
People send me gifts. I don't know, he's gonna stalk me.
No, that guy's, yesterday was Daniel's birthday.
I didn't know we're
filming. Yesterday was Daniel's birthday. Right, Daniel, the HVAC technician. Check him out, DC HVAC on YouTube. Take a look at this filthy evaporator coil. Wow, that is scary. That is pretty scary. Look at the dust is pouring out of it. It's crazy. All right, so one thing that they did here, which is kind of different for this oversized system, by the way, they use inch and an eighth. I keep getting confused because we never see over 7/8 of line set size, but we should cover it up with some tape. Okay. What the
f-
what on earth just happened?
As you said, we should cover
it up. Yo, what happened? Are you kidding me?
Did that come out of the 1 inch? Yeah.
No, it came out of the 1 inch?
Yeah.
How did that happen?
What?
What on earth happened here? Oh my god, it feels like a gremlin spewed on me.
It's oil.
Oh my god. Oh. I have no idea how that happened, but luckily there was a door here that blocked the spray of refrigeration oil. Otherwise, everything would have been covered. But before I was rudely interrupted by that refrigeration oil come popping out of that inch and an eighth line, Peter and I have made a pact. We've made a pact. Packed, right? Wednesday, which is, wow, in 48 hours, I'm going to be sitting for an exam, a state exam. Wednesday, I am sitting for the state of Florida Master Plumber's exam. I've been studying. I'm kind of a little worried about these isometric drawings.
I think you got it.
There's unfortunately 30% ever pass, by the way. If you don't pass the first time, you're never passing, by the way. So I made a pact with Peter that if I pass the exam, Peter and I, together, we're gonna take our ground school class and exam together. That's right. In case you're wondering what ground school means, right? Peter has this fetish for aviation. So do I. right? I don't love going on vacation. I love flying. I absolutely love flying. And if I pass this exam, Peter and I are going to take the ground school class together, and we're going to take the exam together.
And we're going
to
pass.
And we're going to pass together. That's right. We're going to pass together. All right. So while we fantasize about flying, all right, let's put in this Bosch. Let's do it now. Daniel?
Yeah.
9:15. What do you think?
I think it looks good.
I think it looks great. Damn. That looks great. Wow. Very impressive.
All right. So one of the things that we're doing right now, because of the mixed refrigerant, we're not changing the line set because our air handler is on the other side of the house. I would say a good 150 feet away in developed length. Nope, sorry. Developed length, probably close to 200 feet because we go across that away, that away, that away, and to the garage. So we're using the Diversitech Pro Flush, and we're going to follow that up with the pipe wiper system. We don't have the pipe wiper system for the inch and an eighth, the ACR tubing. We only have it for the 7/8, so we're going to use this on our 3/8 right there. There you go. Give it some extra juice. So we're using the Pro Flush. This is great for rinsing all the oils out of the line, any acid. Sometimes you got to do it a few times, but if you do use this and you follow with a nitrogen purge afterwards, you're going to get all that cocky out of there. Nice. All right, so now that we've flushed out our 7/8 going to inch and an eighth, we're going to use the pipe wiper system. This is by Ajax. Yeah, I think they sold their license to Diversitech or Supco. Some other company bought this, but I have the original, the pipe wiper. So we're attaching this contraption, and then we're going to throw a pig in there.
Can we come and get the net?
Nah, you catch it with your teeth. No? So we have the net that catches the piggies as you shoot them through. Here is an assortment of pigs. You can get this at True Tech Tools, I think. Or use, and if you're gonna shop at True Tech Tools, I am not a true friend. Definitely not a true friend. But you can use Know It All, KNOWITALL, and you'll get 7% off your order. And as a YouTube guy, it has a, what?
Here.
Not tight?
Over-tight.
All right, here we go. We're sending the pigs. Got it. Nice. Very nice. We'll do it a few more
putting
times.
Putting the pig in there. And then we're going to shoot it into the line.
This is an easy way to save time and save money on your swap outs from 22 to 14. Got it. That was quick.
Yeah.
What was that, like 2 seconds?
Yeah,
travel like 100 and something feet. Wow. So I'm going to go and show you guys by the air handler what
right,
this
so
looks
here
like.
Here we are.
Don't go yet.
We're going to time it. Okay.
He's gonna say go when he shoots it.
Here we go. I'll hold the timer for you.
I'm gonna say 3, 2, 1, go.
Throw 3, 2, 1, and go when you hit start.
Okay.
All right, ready, go.
Three.
Hold on. Okay, go.
3, 2, 1, go.
That was 1.7.
That was like 1.7 seconds.
Wow.
Wow. Is it oily?
A little bit.
All right.
Okay.
So here's the outlet side of that 3/8. And these little pigs, right here, all right, they don't think they fit in there, but they fit in there.
Shoot through.
So that's 4. Let's do one more. Okay, one more. Got it. Excellent. So the pipe wiper system, ladies and gentlemen, easy way to save time and money on your installs by not having to replace the line set. Again, as long as you don't have any leaks in your line set, this is a great way of doing that. And it is 10:20 in the morning. We started at around 8 o'clock, and air handler's in position. Still got to wire this. We're going to connect our line sets. Still got to do our drains. But we have a really, really, really nice install there, a nice transition piece going to our hydro coil, our fan coil. This is really going to be a really nice system. And what's amazing is that we're taking out a 4-ton system. I don't remember. And we're putting in the right size, which is a 3-ton. All right, 5 minutes after 1, we have been vacuuming this beast down for a good 45 minutes. We've nitrogen purged several times. We're only at 805 microns. That's the problem when you got these older line sets, 1 1/8, and you had that cross-contamination with 410A and R22. We flush it out with the X11 flush. We use the pipe wiper on the 3/8. You can only do so much. You can only do so much. And this thing's been dripping, you know, forever. It is what it is. We're at 798 now. So we are slowly going down, 797. But it is taking its sweet time. You know what? Rome wasn't built overnight. It just takes time. All right, ladies and gentlemen. It is 145. See, 145. There's our Bosch IDS 2.1 connected heat pump inverter. Now, while it's not being utilized for heat pump operation now, it does have that option in the future. I say that now because we only have two wires coming out, Y and C, right? We need that extra wire to operate OB, that reversing valve. Really, really nice. The only thing you hear right now are the other units running. This one's off, that one's running, off, off, off. But you can't even hear that. Whisper quiet. It's a whisper quiet Bosch. I love it. Guys, if you are in the New York, Long Island area, we're based in Valley Stream. We're moving to Woodmere in the next 6-8 weeks. Give us a call, 516-348-6300. If you want to have the most energy efficient system that's available on the market, this is the Rolls-Royce, and you don't have to pay Rolls-Royce pricing. You don't. This is much cheaper than a Carrier Infinity system. Much cheaper. All right? And it does the same exact thing, and it's even better, in my opinion.